you're going to you're going to come around your corner and that kind of establishes your base. So rather than letting you kind of finish the turn, your rotation will still be to the inside, because that's the direction of the lateral bend of her body,
yes,
and that's the hind leg that's going to be doing the hardest work.
Yes.
You'll be using your inside leg to keep asking that inside hind to step under.
Yep.
The
shoulder. Slightly back, the inside leg.
I leave it where it is. Then your outside leg needs to stay hooked around, not off. Your outside elbow needs to stay connected. So you're kind of like this. Then the tricky part is, what I found in my experience is, your inside leg is going to stay, keep stepping that inside hind underneath you. But alternately, your outside leg is staying and keep going straight. So it's like you're doing one and then the other.
Yes.
Tiny.
Yeah.
And you know, fairly, it's pretty subtle.
Yeah.
It's mostly about your body position and keeping that elbow connected, and then just thinking, can I coordinate these legs? So it's not going to be huge for her, but if you get a sensation, good.
Nope.
And the key is, is doing your better.
Really hard, don't you? Yes.
Yes, there. Good.
It's a short, sharp piece.
I know.
That was much better. What I was going to say was, what might help is doing the small circle, then you turn around beforehand and then coming out of that. But you did it well in that corner. That's better.
So much better.
And then you just squint the shoulder a bit. What does that feel like?
It's going to be a
little flash of
I don't really feel it.
It's pretty small. It's a sensation. I try to stop the cues again.
No.
Because I tend to get dirty. That's good right there. And it may be that actually doing it on the circle is easier.
I don't think there's one of the phones or anything.